All right, we got a 2014 Toyota 4Runner, and we are going to be checking codes on the check engine light, and it also has a traction light on. We got the Toyota Techstream factory software hooked up to it, and we're going to go ahead and connect to this vehicle and see what we find. Toyota 4Runner 2014. That looks right. And also, so select the options with or without smart key. This one, has, I believe, does have the smart key. So, bear with me here, it's a little slow. Alright, there we go, we're connected. So let's go ahead and go into engine control module first. I'm just gonna double click on this. Camshaft position A, actuator circuit bank 2. Then we have a startability malfunction. P1604 and a P0020. So it looks like the looks like our P0020 is a current code, so this is a current malfunction, and that is for the camshaft position A actuator circuit bank 2. So that's for the varial valve timing. Alright, so let's go check our stability control codes here. So let's go back to we're going to go back to select system. Then we're going to find ABS and vehicle stability and traction. Double click on that. I'm going to go to trouble codes, and there's no code, so right now the check engine light is causing the traction light to be on. So for whatever reason, on the computer saying because of the engine fault, there's no traction control capability right now, so it automatically shuts it off. Alright, so I'm going to pull up the diagnostic procedure for this code and do a quick visual inspection underneath the hood. Okay, well first we're going to do a visual inspection on this cam actuator, or varial valve timing actuator, you could call it. The code we're getting was a C0020, which is the left bank. On this one, it's going to be on the driver's side, and as you can see, it's underneath the intake manifold there. And I think we got some mice or some kind of rodents here, because it looks like the end of the cable is actually chewed off, and there was some evidence down the intake area of mice being in here. So this one's going to be a pretty easy fix. Just going to have to order a new pigtail and wire it in there. If this wasn't the case, normally what I would do is I would just pull this actuator out and test it right on the bench, make sure the plunger is moving back and forth, check the resistance of the valve, make sure the oil level in the vehicle is proper, which is required for these things to work the way they're supposed to. But quick tip to prevent this from happening, stick mothballs underneath your hood. Okay, I believe we have this circuit all repaired for the P0020 cam position A actuator circuit bank 2.
we ordered a new pigtail and we wired it in, reconnected it. So now we're just going to we're gonna go ahead and get down here and erase the diagnostic trouble codes. We like to clear these codes, clear this. All right, so it's all been cleared out. Shut the car off, restart it, make sure our lights are out. All right, lights are all out, we're looking good. I'll probably do a drive cycle on this just so all the monitors can set, make sure we don't have any other issues, but it looks like this one is fixed.
Be sure to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel if this information was helpful. I'll be posting new videos daily. Thanks again from the Flat Rate Mechanic. Till next time.